Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, heading over to talk to Mr. Evrart Claire. Now we mailed his thing, his signatures. This is the guy. He is apparently, from what Joyce told us, he's a mercenary. What's going on here? So we're not going to talk to him. I mean, I'm guessing we're probably safe in doing so, just approaching him. That, you know, it might just be, you know, don't choose this choice. I know you're a mercenary or something. But just to be safe, we're not going to speak to him at all if we can help it. What is this? Something here. Odd that you didn't catch this graffito earlier. Van Eyck Overdrive, it says. Oh, yeah, we're probably seeing that because... you know, you got there before me. You probably see that because we took something in the thought cabinet that let us see random posters, Van Eyck posters throughout the land. Just because I have anything to say.
Hola, wandering man. How can I help you?
Nothing new. Now we'll turn the music back on. Because out there we get this one theme that gets hit by content ID copyright claim stuff. Oh. Didn't mean to hit that. I don't think it plays out here in the shipping yard. Yes, I like this theme. I like to have the music play as much as possible. It's just too bad I can't include that one theme, otherwise I don't get any revenue for that video. Which isn't a big thing, but it's just annoying to get these claims. Now, I forget who the other guy was. Did they say it was him?
I need to be back to talk with O'Lear here. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. It's like Lady Larice said when she opened...
Yeah, shut up. Okay, Evrart. Whenever, Evrart time. Hello there.
Mr. Dubois, I hear the meeting with Titus was a glowing success. That's such a relief. Titus can be a handful sometimes.
His grin widens.
Now, what can Evrart Claire do for you today?
It's done. I mailed the signatures you asked me to mail. The golden boy returns once more. Wonderful. Simply wonderful, Harry. He claps his hands together like a child who's just been offered cotton candy. Of course, I already knew this. My friend, the mailman, confirms the letter is on its way. You've done a great thing today. You've given the children of Martinez a future and proven to be a true man of the left. I can finally trust you now. The funny thing is, I mean, we got Lily and the rag picker's signature. The washerwoman wouldn't sign, so we've got... what's his name? Idiot Doom Spiral. I don't know if that signature is going to count for anything, being that it's actually Idiot Doom Spiral. I have no idea. That's probably not his legal name. But, I mean, you never know. You're in my inner circle. You too, Mr. Katsuragi. He nods to the lieutenant, smiling broadly. We can talk about anything. The strike, the murder, your lost gun. Nothing is off the table. Drama says, well done, sire. By guile and deceit, you're in. It's dangerous talking about the gun. Let's save that for last. Didn't I almost have a heart attack last time? I know you plan to force them out with the construction noise. Did you order the hanged man killed? Order it? You know my men didn't kill him. They told you. It was a happy accident. You know how it is. No one takes the initiative. If I wanted him dead, I would have had to do it myself. I'm too fat for that. Why are you so fat? Glad you ask. I've got type 2 diabetes because sugar and fat was all my mother had to give me and my brother Edgar when we were kids. He wags his finger at you. Good job, too, as it made me ugly. And ugly people, Harry, are much better at politics. What do you gain from him being dead? Why, a war, of course. Kim says, and what do you have to gain from a war? Victory, Mr. Katsuragi. I have victory to gain. We're going to start a war with the Wild Pines group and win before they even realize there is a war. Do I want to warn him? I think this is warning him. But this is a metaphor, right? Have you heard what two giant Sarais hornets can do to an entire colony of bees? They destroy it. I have. It's a great story, Harry. He nods. Did you also know how the bee colony kills the giant hornet? They swarm and blanket it entirely until it suffers a massive heat stroke and dies. Empathy says, he crosses his hands contently, thinking of the interior temperature of the wasp rising. Harry, we outnumber them 1,500 to 1, and that's just Martinez. With all the unions in Revachol, and with public opinion on our side, we can hold off 2 men, or 15 men, or even 50 men. The more they send, the worse it's going to look for them. They made a huge mistake hiring those guys. No one likes foreign mercenaries. The leftists hate them, the fascists hate them, even the moralists think they're in bad taste. How is this connected to the strike? Harry, there is no strike, only war, class war, or, in business terms, a dawn raid. Or wait, he pauses to rub his chin, is that when you will still pay them something? Because we won't do that. We're going to give nothing. We're not going to give nothing. We're going to take Terminal B away from them. The roads, the gates, the containers, that big crane, even the damn coffee maker. We're going to take all of it for the people and screw Wild Pines. Kim says, so that's why you haven't let Joyce in? Yes, it's also why I let that midget Gaumont go. He's too nice. I can't put him through this. Plus, he knows how to get in here. That woman can't tell her... Okay, I'm not saying that. She has no chance. What? It's a local saying. Rhetoric says, actually, no, it's not. Why are you telling me your plans? Because we're friends, Harry. Besides, it doesn't matter now. You can go tell... you can go tell her if you want. It won't change the course of events. We have a significant head start. He looks at the swordfish clock and nods. It's already happening. How many of you guys are there in the Union? 2,372, he replies like a whip. Plus yours truly, of course. Logic says, that's a sizable contingent for a labor organization in Revachol. Authority says, and they're all well motivated, at least the ones you've seen. How are you going to fund your new independent harbor? Oh, you mean what sort of goods are going to be flowing through? How am I going to replace all the contacts we'll lose once the poo-poo hits the fan? The clients who'll ditch us? Harry, we've thought of everything. Logic says, clients would take a well-known multinational conglomerate over a local mobster any day. Everything? We've been running back channel negotiations with all the major clients. I think the company will be unpleasantly surprised to see how many of them stay loyal to Martinez and to the new competitive contracts we can offer. Breakthrough imminent. Oh, yeah, we got a thought. Almost done. With renewed zeal sparked by communal ownership, the men will be shipping those containers double time. You're surprised to see how fast things go without parasites latching on. We'll have our hands free to pursue bold, exotic new revenue streams. Reaction Speed says, that's drugs. Kim says, drug trafficking. Drug trafficking? Don't be stupid, Mr. Kitsuragi. There are perfectly legal 100% ethical chemical factories on the Samaran Isola. You don't need to be colonialist about it. All they do is produce components to keep the pharmaceutical industry running. That's people's health we're talking about. Old grannies, little babes, people with disabilities. That's just the tip of the iceberg, though, isn't it? The company thinks transporting these chemicals in bulk looks bad, he makes air quotes, has bad optics, may be illegal in some countries. The Debardiers Union, however, we're all about the large volume column. We're going to transport the living daylights out of those materials, Harry. He slams his fist on the desk once more. So your sick kid can get his benefit and your wacky uncle doesn't have to come off risperazole. Level up. Encyclopedia says, Benefit is children's cold medicine, usually apricot flavored, and risperazole is used to treat severe psychosis. Kim says, and the kids on the street can get speed and pyrholodon? I'm an old-fashioned guy, Mr. Kitsuragi. I sometimes grab a beer with the boys, but I have no idea about the things you just mentioned. He smiles. Sure you don't. He's smiling again. But if I were to supply ingredients for some sort of rainbow party, I would make sure the union took a fantastic share, and I'd keep that stuff far away from Martinez. Encyclopedia says he's basically admitting to it. Is Ruby helping you secure this fantastic share? Harry, if I was supplying raw materials to drug manufacturers, I would need an army of rubies. The lieutenant nods slowly. Understood. I have to admit, that's a well-put-together plan and far removed from you. He smiles slyly. It's also far removed from my men and the people of Martinez who have put their trust in me. Anyway, let's not focus on the sensationalism of the drug trade. This hypothetical drug trade is all anyone ever seems to be interested in. I would only be a small part of the harbor's turnover. Or it would only be a small part of the harbor's turnover, just like the harbor is but a small part of Martinez. Go on. Let's look at the big picture. Martinez as a whole. There are little girls out there with dreams of making music. Young mothers who want to start businesses, models who want to walk catwalks, and steel welders who want to weld steel. I'm going to unite them all into one economic body. We're going to incorporate this place to kingdom come. Everyone's going to be in on the wealth, and everyone's going to pull their weight. Volition says, let's keep focusing on the drug trade. He was almost admitting to it. Okay. This is kind of blunt. You almost admitted to? No. No. Hold on. I don't want to look at the big picture. I want to look at the drug trade you almost admitted to. No, Harry. That's boring. Alright, it's gone. The hypothetical raw materials trade is off the table. It's such a small and insignificant slice of revenue, I'm cutting it. I don't think I should believe him. Boys, he looks around in the container. Harry felt queasy about it. We're not doing it. Who's he talking to? Can we talk about my beautiful incorporated Martinez and its many-sided well business ventures now? This bold new vision of incorporated socialism I'm offering? Incorporated socialism. He's slimy. I don't want to say that. That. Flags are kings. It's more like we want a ruler, not socialism. I do have an opinion. It's just not represented here. None of this stuff fits for what I'm thinking. Incorporate? I mean, socialism is great and all, you know, power to the people and everything. In its purest form, anyway. But if we're incorporating it, then it's just another corporation. I love what you're doing for the working man. I don't love what he's doing for the working man. I mean, maybe a couple of the things, but not the drugs and not the The community center is iffy, even though I know I did it. I did the signatures thing. And then the flags and kings makes you think, like, this place should be ruled like a freaking kingdom, like a monarchy. Honestly, it's not my place to judge or express an opinion. I do have one, but... This is the one that fits... is closest to being fitting, even though it doesn't fit. Harry, the length you're willing to go to keep your nose clean is remarkable. He stares at you lovingly. You will always have a warm bed in Mr. Claire's household, my friend, and a special place in the future of Martinese. I'm gonna get to this stuff. Can I ask you about specific union members? We're way past specific union members now. This is the big time. His eyes are shining. We're talking about the future of Revachol here, Harry. You can bother Leonard with that. He points to the door. He loves to run his mouth on such matters, but I'm in big time mode, Harry. Alright. Big time mode. Who killed the hangman? No idea. Could have been his own mother for all I know. If you ever find the guy, give him a big fat kiss from Evrart Claire. Couldn't have done it without him. Drama says he really doesn't know. Reaction speed says, a guy, huh? How do you know it's a guy? I don't. I told you it could have been his own mother. I'm pretty sure it wasn't anyone from the Union. Maybe it was the mob, or maybe he killed himself because he was a closet socialist. Truth is, I simply don't know. Drama says he really doesn't. The signatures I got. I know you plan to force them out with the construction noise. Harry, he shakes his head. By now you should know that I would never do anything tricky like that. Right. However, if the construction noise and limited street access makes some people consider moving, well, let's just say there'll be freshly renovated buildings near the roundabout where those poor people can finally enjoy a significant uptick in quality of life. I'm talking real affordable workers' palaces. So the village is doomed, the lieutenant says grimly. You were there. You saw the place. A wasteland. There's nothing left. But mark my words, officers. He slams his fist on the table, causing some of the coffee to spill. We are going to reset it. Reset, he repeats. I have big plans for Martinez, and they do not include humans living in those pig sheds on the coast. That land will be used for municipal buildings and commerce. Municipal buildings and commerce. Okay, that is not what we... This was supposed to be a community center for kids? What do you mean? Harry, imagine a youth center supermarket church complex. Okay. You're running out of church over there. Employing hundreds, no, thousands of people. The coast will be lit up with enterprise and life. All those ruins out there turned into low-income housing. He leans forward. Harry, enough is enough. We're taking this district back. The war was 50 years ago, for God's sake. It's time to move on. Youth supermarket church complex? Do you really expect me to believe that? Yes, I do. I got the center. I got room for a retail complex, and in 4 years I'll get the church, too. The wheels are already turning, Harry. The wheels of progress. This post-war limbo. I won't stand for it. There are kids practically playing with their own feces out there. It cannot go on. Okay, those were rocks. They were playing with rocks. Empathy says, there is true indignation in his voice when he speaks about the state of things, and even a touch of pain. Pain Threshold says, the pain is true. He's seen the kids do worse than that. Himself? He can't even leave this container, except at night, somehow. Joyce was right when she said you were up to something. Damn right I am, Harry. The fist lands on the table again. I'm gonna make the working man as rich as she is one day. That's my job, just like yours is to keep the peace. I want to ask him about the statue. But will you erect a statue to yourself? I'm not a symbolist, Harry. I'm a realist. My statue will be Martinet's rebuilt. Five-story building complexes, workers on welfare, and landowners in Ozone hating me. That will be my statue. And yours. We're doing this together. Authority says, you would look nice as a statue. Alright. Can I get my gun now? Harry, I've got to be honest with you. He turns solemn. Your gun was found 2 days ago. Withholding this information weighed heavily on me, but it had to be done. You bastard. Your gun is with an old woman, he says, absolutely unperturbed by your outburst. I hear she's a character, so watch out. What's her name? The cryptozoologist woman? Or the other old woman that we talked to about old movies. By the, she hangs out by the lorries. He's not talking about the washerwoman. I'm trying to think of all the old women we've come across. Can't think of anyone else. Logic says, this must be the woman who bought the gun from Roy, the one he described as terrifying. Terrifying. Alright, so it must be her. So the gun's still with the woman who bought it from Roy. Yes, the same one. I see you've done your research. The pawn shop made the gun easy to track. He smiles and shakes his head in wonderment. Crazy stuff, Harry. Selling your gun like that. Wild. Anyway. The neighbors of this old woman contacted my men because they trust me and the Debardieres Union. Apparently she was waving it around at the entrance to her building. She was waving it around at people? As I said, she's a character. I didn't have time for details. He smiles. It sounds like she's unstable, but don't worry. No one got hurt. Who is this old woman? Unfortunately, I don't know any more. You're gonna have to go in blind, Harry. But she's an old lady. How dangerous can she possibly be? Oh, and she calls herself the Pigs. The Pigs? Inland Empire says, there it is again, the Pigs, like Roy said. Not good at all. I don't recall Roy saying anything about that, but that doesn't mean much. That was probably quite a while ago. I, for one, find it refreshing. Finally, someone calls themselves a pig. A smile flickers in the corner of the lieutenant's mouth. Esprit de Corps says, it actually sounds extremely bad, but let's not give him the satisfaction. Can you set up a meeting? Test complete. Confront the pigs. Task gained. I already have. He holds out his index finger. Tonight, starting at 2200, near the old fish market on the coast. The one on the boardwalk, a little past the fishing village. Be careful, Harry. I would never set you up for anything dangerous, but you did ask for this. Now, he claps his hands, back to the fun stuff. But you set it up before I asked for it. Inland Empire says, she will be there from 2200 till 2 o'clock. Oh, 200. Kim says, more fun stuff. He looks at you. Seems like we already have fun stuff to do. Alright, that's it for now. Great, Harry. Great. I think we have truly built a bridge between Martinez and Jamrock today. We have united the RCM and the Debardieres Union. Suddenly there's sadness in his tone. This, he he points to you, then himself, has been so great. I'm sorry we don't have more fun things to do together, but if you ever feel like bouncing something off me, my door is always open. No more questions about the harbor? No. I've just finished investigating the local drug trade. Ah, yes, your side investigation. Thank you. He adjusts his glasses. You've got some spirit, clearing up phony drug accusations alongside this murder. I'll talk to the mayor and see if I can get you the key to the city, Harry. Now let's talk real business. Encyclopedia says, actually, Revachol doesn't have a mayor. Rhetoric says he refuses to discuss it further. It's probably just a small nuisance to him. Empathy says, not even a speck of anger in his voice. That's that, then. I wanted to go over a couple things about me. Let's hear it, Harry. He sinks deeper into his chair. Where did you get that folder? Ah, this? He closes the folder. My friends in your organization gave it to me, Harry. Redrick says, this translates into, haha, you guys are so corrupt. I find that very suspicious, Kim says. May I have a look? I'm afraid this is meant for union eyes only, Mr. Kitsuragi. I'm sure you understand. He turns back to you. Please continue, Harry. What kind of a cop does it say I am? Well, Harry, he turns a couple of pages in the folder. If I were to sum you up in one word, it would be apologetic. That would be apologetic saying that. I'm not apologetic, I'm confident. Well, you sure come off as very confident in all our interactions, Harry. He chuckles. You're a real man's man. Do you know where I live? But of course, Harry, he nods. Your precinct is the 41st and you live in Jamrock. You're a Jamrock boy. A long way from home, but that's okay. Redrick says he doesn't really seem to know any more about it. Getting him better now. Do you know anything about my family? Do I have a wife or kids or... Family? Harry, you're not a family man. There's not one peep of family in here. Unless you think you're a family man? Do you strike yourself as a family man, Harry? You're right, I don't. That's why I like you, Harry. His fat finger is pointing at you. A good man knows both his strengths and his weaknesses. And you, my friend, you are one of the all-time greats. Alright, have another look at that folder. Very high. Plus one for Kim suspects something, and plus one for red shipping folders before. That's right. As you look at the folder, Evrart covers it with his hand and pets it. He's hiding it from you, because it's not a real RCM folder. It's just one of those brown folders you saw in the file cabinet. That's not an RCM folder. Okay, Harry, you got me, he says, grinning. This is from the Census Bureau, not the RCM. Those Census Bureau people are absolutely corrupt. You should do something about them. Kim says he got the name from the Census Bureau and everything else from your actions here in Martinese. Yes, yes, Mr. Kitsuragi, from the Census Bureau, like I said. He looks annoyed. I'm actually a very busy man, so is anything else I can do for you, Harry? Logic says, that means he doesn't really know anything about you. Inland Empire says, a pity. The mystery of you will have to remain a mystery for the time being. So the Census Bureau says my name is Harry Dubois? Yes, that's what I said. Try to keep up, okay? Let's move on. See you soon, Debardier. The big man raises his hand in farewell. Just kidding, but not too much. Huh. Thought complete for regular law official. You've done it, Harry. Whatever else you are, you're also boring now. It was not easy. You spent most of your life trying to funk up every nook and cranny of your personality. When someone says something political, the first three thoughts in your head are a ludicrous hodgepodge of communism, fascism, and stock tips. When they ask you why you did something, it's superstardom, apocalypse, or the mea culpas of a flagellant cop monk. It's not easy, reaching for the fourth option, the normal one, but you have, and now you're not just crazy, you're also boring. Huh. Minus one shivers for strong grasp of reality. Minus one inland empire, dull but solid. All learning caps raised to 3. Yeah, I don't like that one. Bye-bye. Alright. Date of birth generator. Still working on that one. 6 hours. Trying to pick the ones, at least for now, that are 20 hours. Good God. That don't take that long. Oh, this is the one from what's-his-name? Measurehead. I don't plan on taking that one. So that one's an hour 40, hour 30 actual art degree, the art cop. Indirect mode of taxations. And we'll take this one. Okay, so I have 2 skill points. Gonna save them for now. Someone's been running around with your sidearm pretending to be a police officer. You must meet here near the old fish market at 2200 and get your service weapon back. Just past the fishing village until you see the boardwalk. Eight hours. All right, so we've got time for both of these. That's without Kim. So these 3 things, this, and skip Ruby for now, and the choice about the panel, those are for tonight. This we tried. Could not find this. Maybe put in hand-eye coordination. Try this again. And then we got Suna. Which will help with all this stuff. And Tuesday. Yeah, I'm not doing that one. Race Enigma. Let's go back out and talk to this guy. Said I could ask him about specific union members. I don't know if there's anything new. Hello again.
Oh, hey, mister. I need to be back to talk with O'Leary here. Yes, I did. It's like Lady Larice said when she opened a bathhouse in the basement of my apartment building. They can only get so far before they're aching to get back. And a lot of folks really did keep coming back.
Leo, you seem to know everyone around here. I want to ask you about someone. Mr. Evrart doesn't really want me to talk to people about union guys, he thinks for a moment. But who do you want to talk about? Tell me about Manana. Manana. He's a union man through and through. Good guy. He falls silent, hesitating. He's very calm, laid back, doesn't do much, talks to Evrart sometimes. Honestly, I don't know what he does for us, but it must be important because everyone likes him. Yes, they do. I think that's what he does. He makes everyone feel a little better. Tell me about Measurehead. Oh, he's really something. The little man starts laughing. He doesn't talk much to me usually, but when he does, I don't really understand most of what he's saying. He suddenly falls quiet. Actually, I don't think he would like me running my mouth about him like that. Once he said he's a dragon to this fellow mod member who came picking a fight with some union man. Heh, I think he really believed Jean-Luc was a dragon because he ran right off. Another time he almost killed another guy, but I shouldn't talk about that. Tell me about Titus. Oh, Titus is a longshoreman through and through. He was born on a boat, they say. The little man rubs a patch on his elbow. His veins are probably filled with salt water, I tell you. Nice friendly sort, old Titus is. conceptualization says he's probably one of those rare specimens who are born when two drunk seamen stumble on top of each other on the deck amidst a storm so violent it flings whales around. Tell me about Evrart. I'd best not. I mean, I could, but I don't think Mr. Evrart would like it very much if... You better ask him yourself, mister. If anything, the ever-present smile on Leo's face gets even warmer. Tell me about Renee. The night guard? He was a peculiar fellow, headstrong and proud. We didn't really talk all that much. The little guy looks you in the eye. He died recently. Some think with this tinker. Tell me about this Edgar guy you keep mentioning. Mr. Edgar is Mr. Everett's brother. He looks a bit younger, he does, but a very smart fellow. Very smart fellow indeed. He's away on some union business. Not even Revachol, they say. Don't interrupt. All kinds of places he visits. Him and his brother both do when they're on a vacation. Right now it's Mr. Everett's turn to look after the union, but last year he spent a whole winter in South Safray? He chuckles. Left with the first autumn rains and didn't come back before the trees were green again. The little guy chuckles again. Encyclopedia says South Safray. A lot of bulk chemical manufacturing going on there. A lot of cargo shipments being made, too. Alright. We're done here. Yeah, we should be able to take these. It should take these off because the dock worker's gone. Renee's dead. Kim, I've questioned him, and there's nothing coming up to retry. Class here. I'm not gonna bother with that. Feld mural. Yeah, we're gonna do that soon. Trash container I could not find. Map wall. I think we can try that. Warded door. Oh, that's the door. We used the key, so we didn't need to, like, kick it down or bash it down or whatever the hell that we were going to do. And the barbell. Yeah, no. Let's walk over here, away from people. We can try this again. Is that not on there? These we can't try again. Unless we put points in. Backyard wall. Gary's gone. Smoker. Oh, to see what his composure is about or something. A cell. Leanne, we're trying to ask her out. Suggestion. Washerwoman. Okay. I'm going to call an episode here when we're trying to... We're going to try to get in here, and we're going to try to analyze the bullet again. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.